Okay guys, before this video was taken, there's some components here. So this is just only a short video, and I'm going to show you how to test your notebook speakers. Okay, if you take a look at this two plastic, black plastic here, these are speakers, and they have wires. In this setup, one is colored black and white, goes here. The red and black goes to the other speaker. So first is, you need a tester. Could be a digital tester, or could be an analog tester. You set the meter to, this one is times one for the analog, or continuity. Please make sure that your tester is working before. Okay, yes, it's working. For the digital, you put it at continuity. Okay. Some digital testers have like sound, so okay. Now we're gonna trace. We're gonna put either the black or the red prods to the either black or the white connector here for this speaker here. We're gonna test this speaker first. Okay, I'll squeeze it just to make contact with this gold. I'm not gonna touch the other prods, otherwise it's gonna only gonna. If you take a look at the reading, it says 10. It says 10 ohms or 9 ohms. If it's 0, that means it's shorted. Something's wrong with the speakers. If it's like 1 or open, infinity, that means it doesn't have continuity. That means it's also bad. So either 0 or infinity, the speaker is bad. Now we're going to test the other speakers. Now I'm going to put this on the red and the black wires. Yes, I have to squeeze it all the way. It's too. So if you, now it's 9 ohms. So both speakers are good. If you don't have a digital, but you have an analog tester, the same. Put it on the white and the black. If you hear that crackling sound, if you can hear that, that means your speaker is good. Let me read. I didn't read earlier. So what is the reading? So like about 4 ohms. 4 ohms is good. This one here. You hear that cracking sound? That's good. And also 4 ohms. So, both speakers are good. The customer complained that there's no sound, but there is sound on the headphones. So, it could be that the driver, he needs to put a new driver. This is the audio board that goes to this motherboard. Sometimes, you know, when this part, let me see which part is the headphones. Okay, this part is the headphones here. This is the microphone. Sometimes if this is broken, the purpose of this is also a switch. When you plug it in, when you plug the headphone jack, what it does, it disconnects the speakers, and this one, it routes the audio going to the headphones. When you release it, it goes back. This one is going to be open, and this board is going to be off. while the speaker is going to be on. So this is like a toggle switch. The point is, if this is always off, connected to the speakers, that means the headphones is always on. It could be that this one is also bad. I have to check that. The only way to do it, first I'm gonna troubleshoot the software. Worst comes to worst, I'm gonna replace this. Do you know that they're just the same? The microphone jack and the speaker jack are just the same for most. So I can get another similar headphone jack from maybe used motherboard and then take this out and then put another one. So, but I'm pretty sure, customer said the speakers, to check the speakers, I'm pretty sure the speakers are good. So no doubt about it. So now we're gonna head to uninstall the drivers and get an updated driver from Dell and see how it goes. Okay, so but anyhow, my purpose here is to teach you how to test the speakers, and that's it. So thanks guys, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye.